Yo, okay. Now, right before we get started, let's just get this out of the way. A-Force was an ongoing comic book series published by Marvel. It came out in May 2015, and it was part of Marvel's Secret War. Yeah, you remember that storyline. It was created by G. Willow Wilson, Margaret Bennett, and Jorge Molina, who's dope. He's a dope artist. And I messed with the book a little bit. But the book ended in October 2016. So, now that that's out the way, and this is now you understand why this box set was made.
Tally ho! Wings of silver, birds of steel.
Welcome to Saturday Morning's YouTube. If you wonder what Saturday Morning is, it's where we talk about the stuff that we love. Comics, action figures, movies. It's comic book shop discussion. Today we're gonna go over 2017 San Diego Comic-Con Toys R Us exclusive Marvel Legends A-Force Heroine Pack. Not heroine, heroines, the female heroes. This pack retails for about $119. This pack was sold out within hours of it being available online.
Hey, all right. I know a lot of you guys are into your boxes. I definitely take mine off the shelf, but for those of you guys that collect the boxes, let's take a look at this box. This is the front. Pretty good. I think you guys will get a kick out of this. The little side panel, cool art. This is the back, and characters are raised. Like you could scratch them and you could feel them. So I think that's cool for you guys. And then if you look on the inside, it has each character bio, like a quick little saying. But I think that's dope, man. Y'all gonna love it. Let's get into the resale stock of these figures. 220 to 300. I've seen each figure sell individually from lowest $29.99 to the highest 50. And you can, those are eBay prices, of course. I think the stock will stay pretty high on these figures due to I can see someone not wanting every figure. Loki possibly being the big grab on this one. Now we'll get to the figures. Here's a quick shot of all of them together. And again, this isn't, yo, Hasbro's really been doing their things with these molds, these figure choices. 2017 is definitely a standout year for Marvel Legends. I would have never thought in a million years that we'd get an A-Force pack. But hey, these are dope. What we're gonna do, we're gonna start with Singularity. She's the shortest out of the pack. She is basically the younger female version Buck. Think of, yeah, that's a perfect example. She matches her height. It's nice, man. I like this figure. I love the color. I love what they've done with it. It's that clear plastic based off the comic book character. She's supposed to resemble the night sky. And they did a pretty good job on it. You can see the little stars. And this is, mind you, this is a special effect where I black and white everything and just kind of highlight. I wanted to highlight her color because they did such a good job on it. Look at that. And the fate, again, this video isn't doing it any justice. But it's a really, they really took their time with this one, the hair sculpting, the color. Look at that. Because I like my characters to really look like the comic book. That's the most frustrating thing is when I see a character and it doesn't look anything like the comic. And she's pretty spot on. Take a look at her. One last look. Let's compare it to our comic book counterpart. Singularity. Next up. Elsa Bloodstone. Yeah. The idea that this figure's even, they made this figure, says a lot for the direction Hasbro is going. It's no longer, they're not always concentrating on the main figures. You know, we do get a lot of Spider-Mans and Captain Americas. But to see them make Elsa Bloodstone, that we have to give them props for that. And it's a damn good figure. You know, they use the Invisible Woman mold, not for her face, but the body. And they added, they got a new jacket, which is a new part, and that's new with her hair, but, you know, we'll probably see that on some other figures. But I'm not mad at this, man. I've yet to be disappointed by any figure they made this year. The shotguns are detailed well, and they usually skimp on the weapons. They usually make them all scientific-y. But the shotguns look great. I'm thinking about using them for Punisher. One last look at the jacket. It's nice. Look at that. They're not skimping. Next on deck is Pulsar, a.k.a. Photon, a.k.a. Captain Marvel, a.k.a. Death Star. Basically, she's listed on the box as Monica Rambeau, or Rambo, depending on how you sound. Another beautifully sculpted figure. If you look at her face, it almost looks like a Barbie doll. It's combining doll sculpting with action figure. This, I can't think of the adjective or the noun, but look, let's take a look at this figure. She's well done. It's pretty simple, nothing too complicated. But we have to give props to the sculpt right here, especially that jacket. The jacket and the hair definitely stands out. It's not a lazily done figure. They put a lot of details into this jacket. I'm a little funny about those hands though. That's those Moon Knight hands. But let's take a look at the sculpting right here. Look at her hair. It's done really well. And I have the only thing I would say is maybe they should have the option to take the jacket off and give her the look how she is currently. And maybe a different head. Because we're in the age of the two heads with the figure. And if you look at compared to Bloodstone's jacket, it's the same jacket except Bloodstone's jacket was open a little more. Here we go right here. But just look at this. Really, really, it's going to look great on the shelf. I can't really see anyone complaining about it. Again, this pack is, so I'm impressed with this pack. That's her in comparison to her comic book counterpart. Good to go. Let's go to Sif. She's another great figure. I love how they utilize Angela's sculpt. Definitely some new unique parts. Almost remind me of Big Barda from DC. But if you take a look at that, it's spot on with the comic book. Take a look at those legs. We know that belongs to Angela. She wore it first. But what I do appreciate, I appreciate Marvel utilizing parts to make good figures. And who would thought in a million years we'd get a Sith figure? It's going to go great with the Thor wave coming out soon. Look at that. It's the red. It's real simple. And I like this cape. This cape makes me think that we're going to probably get some Hellfire Club stuff coming up, definitely with the Mutants. Let's take a look at her side profile. Nice. You know, their weapons, I prefer Marvel Select weapons, but I'm not a complainer. She looks very accurate, almost accurate with her comic. She's wearing more clothing, unlike Angela, which is still a top-tier figure, very slept on, because they did a good job on her as well. This is Sif. You know, either... I'm curious to know what the complaints are going to be with this one. I'm impressed with it. It worked for me.
Female Loki.
Let's get into this one. Definitely a good job as far as her comic book comparison. I like her, man. Look at that hair. I like how they added the little details to the hair. And the face sculpt, and definitely I like the little details they put into this. It was very simple, but it worked. Those boots, I think Rogue had those boots. Actually, they're using the same buck, the athletic female. The athletic female buck, the thick one, I should say, for lack of a better term. And, you know, they have the scales painted on. They're not detailed scales. And there's that cape we talked about with Sif. These praying hands, I really wish they would have two sets of hands if they're going to have a figure like this. But overall, I'm really satisfied with this figure. Lady Loki. Bam. In your face. Oh. She-Hulk. Next up, we got She-Hulk. It's pretty... I think on the shelf, this might be a peg warmer. I don't know. It depends on how many She-Hulk fans we have. It's a basic figure. Its simplicity is what makes it good, though. It's the big woman, the strong woman buck utilized by Valkyrie. It's pretty, it's standard. Like, I could see someone mistaking this for a 3.75. Like, oh, is that 3.75? Nah, 6-inch, buddy. But and this is her in comparison to, I can't think of her name. You know who I'm talking about. Look, yeah. Y'all let me know. I can't think of her name. It's driving me crazy. But yeah, and I feel like they should have modernized her a little more. I think they could have did more with that face sculpt. And maybe modernize her costume a bit more. Because that's a basic She-Hulk costume. But me, I'm a fan of the modern look. And I guess it is it. But I don't know. They could have did a different costume maybe. Something that still says iconic She-Hulk, but something different. But I like it. I'm not fronting on the figure. I like it. Sturdy. Fits on the shelf well. She-Hulk, get it, girl. Get it, girl. Yay! All right. Now we come to the end. Just one last shout out these figures. A Marvel Toys R Us A-Force Pack exclusive. This was fun. Can't wait to do more of these reviews for you guys. They dope. I'll see y'all on the next episode of Saturday Mornings. Yeah. Peace.